Okay, so I've opened up the hands image here. I'm using image 8606, and I've opened up the eye image, and I'm using image 8575. So this one is quite sharp and in focus, and we're just going to use this area here, so it's perfect. The hands are also in good sharp focus too, so this file works well. When you open up the raw files, you may be taken to camera raw filter first, where there's all these adjustments. Don't make any adjustments there. Instead, just open the file as it is, and we'll make our adjustments a little bit later. When the images are imported, you'll find that they're actually quite large in size, and we need to just reduce those so that Photoshop will run more smoothly. So I'm going to go to image, image size. You'll see here that the width is 43, almost 44 centimeters. So I'm just going to reduce that down to 25, which is still quite big, but it reduces the file size quite significantly. The image resolution remains at 300, which is what we want. We want to keep our images at a good quality so they don't become pixelated. So the image is resized. When I zoom in, you can see that the quality hasn't been changed in any way. Same thing here, image, image size. So this time it's the height that's nearly 44. So I just reduce that again to 25. Press OK. Done. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to remove the background from the hands. And there's a pretty simple enough way to do it. And that's through an AI feature that Photoshop has in this version, which is Adobe 2021. It may not grab everything. There are issues down here with some of the shadow that quite blends in here. But we can always use our pen tool to fix up any issues that we find. So we go to Select, Select and Mask. And then I'm going to go to Select Subject. And this is where AI comes into effect and tries to pick out what it sees as the main focus, the hands, and separates that from the background. Okay, so you'll see that it's doing a decent enough job around here, but then inside here, not so much. But as I said, I'm just going to use the pen tool to fix up these areas here. So to do that, I just press OK. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a layer mask on this layer here. So click Layer Mask. And it just cuts out most of the background here, and I can fix up some of those issues with the pen tool. So I'm going to grab the pen tool over here. I'm going to zoom in very quick. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out a section here and create a layer mask. So you can see the layer mask removes the background, makes it transparent. But if we want to, we can always bring it back to the original photograph. So working the layer mask, I'm just going to click down here, follow the line of the arm. Up into the hand, and that's pretty easy going. Just come out here, join up this area, curve of the hand, down here, and just down to this area, Command Z if I make a mistake, here, and over here. Now I'm going to right click or control click. Make selection, press OK, and I'm going to make sure that my foreground color is black. You'll see that the transparent area in the layer mask is black. The part that we see is in white. So when we add black to this, it'll become transparent. If we add white to this area, it'll come back the background. So I'm going to go to the Paint Bucket tool, and I'm just going to click on that there. Now I've made sure as well that it is in the layer mask and not on the layer itself. I see there's a little bit of an issue here. That's easy to fix. I'll just grab the brush and I'll just go over that. I'm going to bump up the opacity, which is transparency. And I'm just going to bump that up so we get rid of that quite easily. And I'll stand it a little bit down here too, a little bit down here. Okay, and I think that's pretty much that. There's a little issue here that I'm going to fix too. Command D, Zoom in. Same thing as before, using the paintbrush tool and the brush to clean up if I need to. Command D. Okay, so we got the general shape of the hands here. Command A to select everything. Command Shift C to copy merged. Over here, Command V. Command T to transform. My width and my height are locked so that when I adjust here, it's not going to affect anything. It's not going to stretch anything out. Zoom in. Okay, so we're starting to see how this is going to work. It's okay with that. So we're going to be cropping this area here. So to do that, just click on that layer. I'm going to double click on it. At the moment, it's locked in as a background. I'm just going to change this layer's name to Eye. The crop tool, I can then bring in this area here. Bring this part in. Bring this up. Drag this down. And I can then just move it around a little bit until I'm kind of happy with the general shape of it. Okay, now I can play around with this a little bit more. I can crop more off if I want to. But for now, I have the basic ingredients of the composition. The next step that I'm going to do here is I'm going to go into filter, camera raw filter. And I'm going to adjust just some of the vibrancy around this. So I'm going to increase the exposure. Bring down the contrast a little bit, bring up the clarity a bit so I get some more detail and texture. Bring out the highlights. Pump up the shadow. The whites a bit as well. A little bit of the black. I want to bring down the vibrancy and saturation a little bit, very, very little bit, because if you do it too much, it becomes... Actually, we're going for black and white for this, so yes, I'm going to bump it down actually completely. And that's going to change things as well quite a lot. So I'm going to bump up the exposure. Clarity a little bit more. Okay, so I think I'm okay with this. Now I can apply the same thing to the hands, but I'm a little bit worried because the hands are quite bright. If I do the same, so if I go to filter, and you'll see this is the camera raw filter settings I used last time. This is to apply a new setting. So I'm just going to repeat that and see what it looks like. You can see it's a little bit too bright. So I'm going to Command Z that. Instead, I'm going to go in there and I'm going to deal with that a little bit differently. So first thing I'm going to do is get rid of the saturation. I'm going to bump up the exposure a bit, but not to the same degree. I'm going to bump up the clarity. Quite a bit. Bring out a little bit of the whites, a little bit of contrast. See how that looks. I can play around with this a little bit more. In the meantime, I'm just going to rename the layer hands. I'm going to turn it off. What I want to do here is I want to cut out the pupil and drag it down below the eye a little bit so it looks like the hands are taking it away. I think that's similar to the image that we were looking at before. So to help us do that, I'm going to use the marquee tool here. And I can try to create a circular image here. And to help me to do that, I'm going to bring in the rulers. So I'm going to press Command R. And then we get these height and width rulers. If I click on this area and hold it down, I can drag a ruler all the way down to the edge of the iris there. And that's a guide that I can work with. Click here and drag it down. Again, holding it, drag it all the way down. And then I got that just above the top of it. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to View and make sure that my smart guides are on. So Show, and down here, Smart Guides. Okay, smart guides are going to help me to be able to draw that circle just right and to make sure that I'm connecting to this area. So go right in here and click and hold down Shift, and that will give us a perfect circle. Let's just move in a slight bit. So I'm going to go just here, click, and hold out. I think I might be able to work with this. So I'm just going to take the selection, Command J to duplicate it. Let's just undo that. It's above the hands. I'm not quite sure why it's including the hands in it, but I'll work around it. So this is the part of the eye that we're going to work with here. Now what I can do is I can just take this tool here, which is a clone stamp tool. I'm going to bring down the brush size a little bit by using the left bracket on my keyboard, which will reduce the size. The right bracket will increase it, and you can find those beside the letter P on your keyboard. So I'm going to bring that down a bit more, bump it up a tiny bit. I'm going to take some of this section here, hold down Alt, A-L-T on your keyboard. It does that. I click once, I let go, and what that does is it takes that section and it brings it down here. I can use that section to help to build up an area similar to what's there and erase this part of the skin. So I'm going to do the same for this area here. Alt click, I'm going to bring this down a bit. In here, and being very careful not to go over the edge. And if I want to be absolutely sure that I don't, I can just click the magic wand tool here. Go back in with the clone stamp tool. That'll make sure that I don't. Command Shift I to make sure that it's only affecting inside, shouldn't get anything outside. Yeah, that's perfect. So again, Alt click and bring that down. Take a little bit of this section here and bring that down. So I'm just covering up that lighter area here. Now I got to be careful that I don't overdo it, because then it's not going to look so natural anymore. So I'm going to take this section here, Alt, create a new section. You want to here. And then I'm just going to use a blur tool. I'm going to bump this up. This is quite low on 38, and that's fine. I don't want to overdo it, or it looks a little bit unnatural. That would be fine. And I'm also going to use here the burn tool, which is going to make this edge a little bit darker. But I got to be very careful I don't overdo it, because then it starts to look a little bit unrealistic. So just around here will be good. Make this area a bit darker. And D, this should be okay for us. What I can do is I can just take this layer and drop it down a bit. Now there's a little bit of repeating going on here, so I want to try and fix this up a little bit more. So I'm going to jump back into it, and I'm just going to Go back in the clone stamp tool, take some of this texture here, alt, click, and here I'm going to bring the opacity down. And that's going to add the texture. Actually, before I do that, do the same thing. Magic wand tool, command shift I. Again, that'll keep me just inside here. Clone stamp tool with 41% should be okay. And that's just going to break up the texture a little bit. So it's not going to look too similar. I'm going to take a bit over here, alt, click, just add some of this, and just clicking and holding down and dragging, but it just looks a little bit different from what's going on up here. Just kind of smoothing it out a bit. That should be okay. Command D. Okay, I think it looks better. I'm going to take this and I'm going to drag this down a bit. Reintroduce the hands up above this layer and above that layer, and we start to get an idea of something happening here. I'm going to command T with the hands and just bring them in a little bit closer. We want to kind of have this part of the hand over the front, and this part we want to make sure that we can get it disappearing behind a little bit, and that'll make it look a little bit more realistic. Okay, and I'm going to bring this down a little bit here too. Okay, so what I need to do now is to remove these fingers here and have them going behind. So to help me do that, I'm going to click on the hands layer. I'm going to click on the magic wand. Let me see if I come up here to the hands layer then. Mask. Okay, and it does that. That's fine. It might not look fine, but it is. I'm just going to reduce the opacity. Okay, this one actually. What I'm going to do actually is I'm going to command J to duplicate the hands. I'm going to here delete the layer mask. Right click, delete the layer mask so I can see what I'm looking for. And I'm just going to select outside the hands, command shift I, and I turn that off. Now what that does is it gives me more of the selection of the hands here, so I can start to see what I want to keep and what I want to lose. I'm going to go into the hands layer mask with black selected and my brush selected here. I'm going to just command plus to zoom in. I'm going to bring back this part of the hand. I'm just going to reduce the opacity a little bit. So I can get a bit more of a blend. Oh, command Z. It's actually white. Lift that over. So again, I can just bring in the hands. I'm going to just do the edge here first. I'm going to come out this side then. Come up to the fingers and thumbs. I'm just going to get a little bit more careful where I'm here, because I don't want this finger to come back. So just bringing this back a little bit, I'm going to use that to guide me. So this is on, but at the same time I'm still working on this layer mask. I'm just using this to help for me to see where I need to go. Command plus. I'm going to reduce the size of this and just click here. I'm going to click a few times. Come down here and just go down, and then I turn that off and I can see that I've got my thumb coming back into play, and that's working okay. This finger here comes out a bit, so I'm going to again turn this back on. I'll follow the edge of this a little bit more, and down here too. Again, this on so I can see it a bit better. And minus. Okay, so that helps me to remove some of that area here. And the same thing here. This is a guide to help me to know what to keep and what not to keep. So I'm gonna go in around here. making sure this part is solid. And then just erase this part over here and the edge of the thumb. And again, you can see there's a little bit of gray from the other layer. I'm just removing that. Coming back over here. Now this is where I'm going to sort of get a bit careful, bring this back. I don't want this finger to reappear, but I maybe want to take some of this and bring it back this way. Let's turn it off and see what we can see. So again, I'm following this finger here. Command D, and I'm just going to hide those guys, command and colon, and that gets rid of that. I'm going to go back to the eye here. I'm going to bring in burn tool again. I'm just going to try to make this area a little bit darker on the eye here too. It's just a little too light.